the older I get, the more I start to understand that not everything needs to be answered or understood. There's so many times where I'm lost or I feel confused about what's going on in this world, what's going on in my life, with my goals, with my plans, the timing, and I start to overthink and question everything. And as a kid, that was kind of what I did. I questioned everything. My mother allowed us the space to ask questions and to be curious and to always be researching and studying things. And since then, I've been that way my entire life. It helps in a lot of situations because I do learn a lot. Every day I'm learning something new. So I have more to pull from and I have more to reference when I get into certain situations. But it also tends to make me overthink. Some answers that God has, that the world, universe has, I'm not necessarily supposed to know. And I think a lot of times people, we try to coach God. We try to put boundaries on God or limits on God or time constraints. And we always want to look for answers. We always want God to explain to us why things are the way they are or when things are going to happen or change. And we talk. And the cool thing about God is you can talk to him like anybody else in the world. With respect, of course. But when I talk to God, I'm not coming to God holier than thou. I'm not coming to God as if I'm some perfect being, because I'm not. I'm coming to God as humble as I am, right? And I'm talking to God. If I got an issue, if I got a question, yo, God, what's up? I'm not understanding this. Yo, you told me this. You told me you'll protect me. You told me you'll do this, do that. Why is this going on right now? I'm not understanding, bro. I still trust you. I still love you, but I need some answers, man. Can you explain that to me? And he doesn't always explain it to you. But is he supposed to? You ever think that maybe some of the things we're shielded from are protecting us? Same with your parents, right? When you grow up, your parents, depending on who they are, they might shield you from certain things. And you think that they're trying to handicap you. But they're trying to protect you and prepare you for whenever you do have to face said thing. Yo, I swear I spent so much time wondering about things and begging God to do this, begging God to do that. You know what I've been practicing lately? For probably the past 6 months or so in a year, I listen a lot more. Like I said, you can go to God, talk to him. Hey, God, I'm worried about this. Can you help me out? That's beautiful. But we don't listen enough. Remember your parents would tell you not to do something and you so hard-headed that you're going to do it anyway. And then when you mess up, now you go to them looking crazy with your tail tucked behind between your legs. And they still love you and embrace you. That's what parents do. But you knew you shouldn't have did what you did. You don't listen. We don't listen. But it's time to start listening. Yo, I sit now when I meditate, right? And when I pray, after I get my speaking out, I spend a few minutes just to sit and to listen. I'm not speaking anymore at that point. Because what else is there left to say? I've said everything I've given my peace. I've expressed myself in however way I needed to. Now it's time to listen. Give God time to speak. Give the world, universe time to figure things out for you, or to show you what things are supposed to be. Yo, when I write songs now, I was talking to a friend, and it's crazy because I was talking about my songwriting process and how I kind of write in a subconscious state, right? I write in the back of my mind. I don't necessarily sit down and craft verses. It's very rare that I'll do that. I usually write verses when I'm at the gym or when I'm at work or I'm taking a walk or even in my sleep. I think in my sleep, naturally, I'm listening. I have no choice but to listen when I'm in my sleep. So I think sometimes I'll wake up and I'll play a beat in my head and I'll play the beat overnight and I'll wake up. And once it's seeped into my subconscious, I'll wake up with a concept. I might wake up with a verse. I might wake up with a hook. And that's how my songs a lot of times get written. It's like that. It's not me sitting down saying, let me pen this verse. When I wrote The Void, I had some of my favorite lines ever in that song. And I don't take credit for writing any of them. Because I didn't speak in that song at all. I listened. I let God speak through me. I had some lines where I said, I'm God's son, infantile. He who never sins is who forgives the child. But I ain't cracked my Bible open in a while. And I ain't living wild, but I can't stand to see the madness. Social media made most of us take commandments from a tablet, but my standards been established from the moon and from the sun. And the more I taste my blood, it's way more ruthless I become. I got a few that might cut through and I'm pursuing every one. I'm moving units off my truth, and I'm going to do it till it's done. I gave my crews a fix. I know my moms would do it for a son. So I've been using up my funds to shoot these videos. Many goals on my docket. I'm a profit off this music in my lungs. Because the more I share my soul, it's way more human I become. All of that, the religious wordplay and all this stuff, bro, I don't take credit for most of my best lines, especially in recent memory, because I'm no longer speaking, I'm listening. And I guess that's just what the message is. This video is not super orchestrated or planned out. I don't even know what I'm gonna talk about. I just put the camera on because I had something on my mind about listening. Somebody asked me how you did this. I listened. I stopped telling God what to do. I still talk to him. I still ask him questions. I still go to him. Still trust him, confide in him. But more than anything now, I'm thanking him. I'm thanking him for placing me in this position. I'm thanking him for everything I've been through, everything I'm going to go through, everything I've overcome, everything I will overcome, everything I'm going to achieve. I thank him for the breath in my lungs. I thank him for all my senses. I thank him for my health. I thank him for a sharp mind and quick wit. I thank him for drive. I thank him for hustle. I thank him for work ethic. I thank him for focus. I thank him for unwavering confidence, almost to a fault sometimes. I thank him for that. It makes me me. I thank you for everything, man. And I sit here and I listen and I let the verses come. I let the words come. I let everything come to me that's supposed to come to me. So many of us just try so hard to force life to happen, yo. Stop forcing life to happen. I saw something today. I was doing a meditation today. And the meditation, you know the quote where people say things don't happen to you, but they happen for you? When you're in that realm of manifestation and law of attraction and things, they say that you should say things happen for me, not to me. Because when you say to me, it places you at the whim of external circumstance and you don't have the power to control your life and your outcome. But I heard something today that was powerful. And it said, things don't happen to me, they don't necessarily happen for me, but they happen with me. Which is like when you're in accordance with nature, when you're just doing what you're supposed to do on the earth, there's no confusion. Every day you're a master creator. You're creating realities that didn't exist before. So life, it happens with you, which means you have the power to influence it. It's not something that can be thrust upon you, right? You just have to embrace it. So understand that everything you see around you, every way your life changes, you're creating this stuff, man. You're creating. Every day you are creating. You were put here by the creator to create. We weren't handcrafted by the creator to be created. We were handcrafted by the creator to be creating. You know what I'm saying? To be creators. That's what we're here for, to create, to express. Life is simple. Life is very, very, very simple. Not easy. I'll say it again. It's not easy. It's simple. Empty yourself. Empty yourself every chance you get. You don't know how many chances you will get. Give it all to this world, man. You know what? It's so disrespectful to not give all of us to the world. It's disrespectful to you, to your family, to the rest of the world, to God himself. Because he didn't put us here to be average. He put us here to shine. So when you're going through your tough times, you're fighting off self-doubt and you're wondering when things are going to work out, stop forcing God to answer you in your time and trust in divine timing. And listen, the more you listen, the less you speak, the more answers you'll have. I promise you.